Hey guys, today's video is about model evaluation. We are going to finish this section by discussing Bootstrap technique. In specific, we'll talk about 0.632 Bootstrap technique. This is a non-parametric technique, which means we don't make any assumption about the sample distribution. To illustrate, the sample could belong to any type of population, such as bimodal, unimodal, or uniform. But we don't assume our data is from any of them. We just directly do the validation process. Because we want to estimate the sample distribution, we resample the data and form a simulated population. So the process is like, we first draw a sample from our database. Then, we record the data we just drew. After recording, we put this sample back to the database. In fact, this is what we call the sample with replacement, because we put the sample back. By doing so, the database always has the same number of samples, so we don't need to worry about the number of data points we collected is sufficient or not. Next, we repeat this process several times, so it's called resampling. One thing to note is that there are always some samples that are never drawn, since some samples are drawn multiple times. Generally speaking, after drawing samples from a database n times, which is the total number of data points, around 63.2% of data is drawn at least once, and 36.8% of data is never drawn. So, this method is called 0.632 Bootstrap. Alright, now we can talk about the procedure. Suppose our database contains 20 samples, and the samples are either orange or green. We first draw a sample from the database, and in this case, the sample is green. Then, we record the sample we drew, so you can see a green point in the record. Afterwards, we put this sample back to the database, so the size of the database is never changed. Next, we repeat this process n times. Therefore, we repeat the process 20 times, because we have 20 samples in the database. After we are done, we have this record with 20 data points we just drew. As we said before, roughly 63.2% of data is drawn at least once, but 36.8% of data is never drawn. What we do is separating the samples that are never drawn from the remaining ones. Following this, we use the data in the record as training set, the data never drawn as testing set. However, unlike the traditional method, we don't use training sets to train the model, and the evaluation of model performance is not just based on the testing set. It's because the model is predefined, so we don't need to train a model on our own. Further, the overall accuracy is 0.632 times the accuracy of the model on the testing set, plus 0.368 times the accuracy of model on the training set. This is kind of like the estimation of accuracy because we also use sample to estimate the population distribution. Another thing is that the evaluation measure doesn't have to be accuracy, but accuracy is pretty popular. Next, we repeat the whole procedure k times. That is, we draw the sample, record it, put it back to the database, split the data into training and testing set, and calculate the accuracy k times. K is defined by the user, and just like the cross-validation, 10 is a popular choice. Last, the final accuracy of the model is the average of all the accuracies. To be more specific, the model is always the same one, but the data changes each time. Alright, that's the basic procedure of Bootstrap. In a nutshell, we just want to evaluate the model performance, I mean a single model. So we resample the data multiple times and use a specific formula to estimate the performance. Let's look at its pros and cons. The first advantage is that it's particularly suitable for small datasets because we sample the data with replacement. The size of database never changes, so we don't really need to worry about the data size. Second, since we create many simulated samples, we can calculate the standard errors or confidence interval, these sorts of things. This is useful in the domain of statistics, where we want to know the population distribution. However, this method is not as strong as cross-validation in terms of model validation. This is because when doing Bootstrap, we draw some samples and pretend they are in a population distribution. But sometimes they are not. So we kind of introduce the bias when estimating model performance. Next, this method is not suitable for certain distributions, such as distributions without finite moments, or a situation like the database has extreme values that don't belong to the population distribution. However, it's really difficult to find out this problem because we don't know the exact distribution. All we can do is to estimate it, so we need to examine whether the estimated distribution is reasonable or not. Congratulations! We've finished the second section, model validation. Next time, we are going to talk about ROC curve. Thank you for watching my video and hope you enjoyed it.